1985, San Antonio. San Antonio was my first action and ADAPT's first hit on a regional APTA, the American Public Transit Association, conference. We stayed in a convent, and our rough ways were not too pleasing for the nuns. The place had a kitchen, meeting rooms, a little bunk bed, sleeping rooms. The doors of many rooms were too narrow to get in, and nothing was really accessible, but we made it work. Mark Ball and a group of others came out when I arrived. He walked and had a portable vent thing with him at all times. They immediately started in with a lecture on the politics of oppression. They were so tough, so ready to cut through the crap. My heart opened and I thought, this group is something real. Back then, we had a group meals for dinner. We were much smaller in numbers, about 40 people, but it felt like an army. When I went inside, everyone was in a big meeting discussing the targets and tactics for the next day. Everyone was talking. The dishes from dinner were in the sink. I went in to wash them. It was clear the folks who had cooked were listening intently to the discussion, and they were going to do attendant work when it was done. Dishes were the least I could do. The discussion debate went on for hours as the group thought about the strategy and tactics for the upcoming days. All the Texans slept in the sitting room together. I was the only woman in the group, and they insisted I take the couch. It was so quaint and gentlemanly. The next day, Wade brought everyone straw cowboy hats to wear. We loaded into vans and drove downtown. We had lots of vans, and we packed in tight. Some of the local disability community joined us as we marched around the Alamo with signs calling for lifts on buses. We went over to the lobby of the hotel where APTA was meeting and took over the lobby. With its open atrium, our chants echoed all through all the floors. Finally, Jack Gilstrap, the executive director of APTA, came down to meet with us, but he refused to budge. He would not support lifts on buses. We took off in pairs and trios as planned, fanning out across downtown. Our demand was a meeting with the then-mayor, Henry Cisneros. We had no cell phones or radios, yet we simultaneously started blocking buses all over downtown. It was my first time, and I was with Mel Conrady and George Florham. They told me it was easy, two in front and one behind, making sure to stick out so the driver would see you in the rearview mirror. Mel looked so mellow, it was hard to believe he was going to be doing what he was doing. George had the biker look down to a T. We waited for the bus to stop for the red light, and boom, we were rolling off the curb cut and were in front and then behind the bus. My heart was pounding through my rib cage. We had about 20 pairs, but in the end, the only ones arrested were two people who couldn't find an unblocked bus and got frustrated and blocked the car instead. Cisneros quickly agreed to meet with us on Wednesday. The next day, I had to go back to work, but the group took over the Via Transit office, paratransit. I came back to tales of the ringing a giant bell in their lobby for hours on end, of sticking crutches through the double swinging doors and wheelchairs everywhere in the office. The transit director, Wayne, quote, lifts on San Antonio buses over my dead body, Cook, sounded wild. Day three, we met with Cisneros in the convention center. He seemed truly interested and promised to make changes, which he actually later followed through on. The media, though they covered our issues and us, were also full of happy locals riding Via Trans paratransit. Some locals had bravely marched with us and spoken out to the media in support of our goals, risking retaliation from the notoriously oppressive Via Trans. A local cartoonist, Leo Garza, did a series of Nacho Garacho cartoons on our issues with the transit pros. After Cisneros, we went back out and were going to ride the trolleys. They were not accessible, so a couple of others and I crawled on different trolleys. Once I was up and in my seat, I could not remember a more beautiful and peaceful tour of San Antonio, like a completely different city. The experience underlined for me how the other half lives and why we need to do what we are doing.